We are finally approaching the end of my storage nightmare saga. I hope. To catch everyone up, in spring 2016, I had my main storage raid crash and I lost a bunch of data. I got a QNAP NAS in for review right around that time, moved what I could save to that while I fixed my computer, and then a SATA port on that NAS died. I swapped units and it erased my RAID volume when it tried setting it back up, and I lost a lot more data. I also started trying to heavily leverage the Amazon's alleged unlimited cloud storage plan that I had picked up in holiday 2015 to try and save my bacon. Amazon killed their unlimited plan in the US, and I haven't had the raw disk space at home to download what I had up there, and began to panic earlier this year about what will happen to the rest of what little footage archive that I have left from the past couple years. Through the year, I've developed a working relationship with Synology, and my incredible contact over there has dealt with my panic and stress and worked with me to sponsor me with some storage. First, we set up my edit bay, which I had made a video on early in the year so that I had reliable storage to edit from with their DiskStation DS916 Plus. I've been keeping all of my footage on there and editing right off of it. Now they've sent out the DX513 expansion bay for the DS916 Plus, and we've partnered with WD to utilize their incredibly reliable RED NAS drives for this expansion, and we're going to be setting up an even bigger storage array in the near future. But first, the expansion. My problem was that I had roughly 40 terabytes of raw data up on Amazon Cloud Drive that I needed to download as soon as possible, but I didn't have 40 terabytes of usable space. As I worked on my massive 8-plus terabyte OBS master course, my main 12 to 15 terabyte edit bay quickly filled, leaving me with no room to keep trickling my Amazon backups down to my network. I consulted with Synology, and the best course of action to just get my Amazon data downloaded for me to sort and deal with once I knew it was safe was their DX513 expansion unit. This is a 5-bay unit that just connects to the main DS916 Plus NAS via an eSATA connection. Installation could not have been easier. Literally just screw in the cable and plug in the power cord. We're good to go. In the NAS, WD sent over 5 of their 8-terabyte RED drives, a very reliable and respectable drive among data hoarders such as myself. My main desktop storage drive in my workstation rig is actually an 8-terabyte RED as well, labeled Jean Grey in Windows, for those of you who like to comment on my drive names. These disks are reliable and perform quite well in exactly these scenarios, and you can virtually always get a great deal on them. They even have 10-terabyte REDs available now, too. I connected the expansion bay, booted everything up, and went to the storage manager in the DiskStation Manager OS. Here, I told it to expand my volume. I just want all of my data in one place, right? Well, I'm not sure I'd recommend doing that. Setup time would have been a small number of seconds if you make a new volume with the expansion. I, however, told it to expand my existing 15 terabyte RAID that was already 98% full, and it took an entire week, limiting the NAS's performance throughout. I wasn't exactly prepared for this, but once I realized it was okay to keep using the NAS during this process, it wasn't a huge deal. It was a little bit slower, but I still had my data accessible. Things actually sped up significantly once I was able to utilize a couple external drives to offload about 4 terabytes of data so that it had less data to crawl and more space to move the bits around the platters. Once completed, I now have roughly 49 terabytes of working space, plus some redundancy thanks to the Synology Hybrid RAID and ButterFS. Perfect. That's really all it took. This is why I've been in love with Synology systems for the past couple years now. Their DSM operating system works much like a normal desktop OS, and managing file systems and the like doesn't get complicated at all, unless you want it to. Despite being a storage nerd, I get easily overwhelmed by the plethora of tiny details and inner workings of various file systems and RAID types. I understand the basics, but I don't want to be responsible for making all of the decisions, the correct decisions, at any given moment. I want a smart system that lets me choose my needs and handles the rest for me and Synology's network-attached storage servers do just that. Now, as an added bay, I've actually sacrificed a potential performance opportunity by not utilizing a SSD cache. I needed as much raw capacity as possible, so I filled every slot with platter drives instead of utilizing that handy feature of Synology's hardware. But, to be honest, it wouldn't have made a huge deal for me anyway. My high bitrate DNX HR and ProRes footage is currently fully saturating my gigabit network, and I only use projects once pretty much, you know, I edit them and then I'm done with them, for the most part. And so only minor graphic assets and music tracks that I frequently use would really be served well by caching. In the next phase of my storage buildout, I'm making a similar sacrifice for this reason. I'll be making the push to 10 gigabit networking, which I am so excited for, to eliminate the 1 gigabit per second transfer bottleneck that I've been running into, and I won't be utilizing a cache on that either. I'll just be having the 10 gigabit throughput, which I'm unbelievably excited for. Until then, I'm just grateful to be pulling what data I can from Amazon's honestly horrendous consumer service, and to at least know that my data is safe for now. The next phase will involve building out enough storage to last a while so that I'm not making these update videos quite so often. With my OBS course project taking up 8 terabytes, clearly bulk storage is a necessity, and I'm beyond hyped to show you what we're doing next. My undying gratitude to Synology and Western Digital for sponsoring this video series, my sanity, and making this all happen. Product links to Synology servers will be in the video description, as well as WD drives. Go pick some up for your storage needs. I'm Epos Vox, here to make tech easier and more fun. And remember, no data is ever safe on RAID 0. And to always have multiple backups in multiple places. Don't be me. Just don't do it.
Epos Vox is a Patreon-supported production. Our videos would simply not be possible without the support and generosity of our patrons, whom you can see on screen now. If you'd like to join the inner circle and get early access to videos, among other benefits, go to patreon.com/eposvox to learn more.